We're getting reports there's been a major security incident involving Israeli soldiers on the border with Lebanon. Israel said on Monday it had sent ground troops into Lebanon and what it said was a targeted operation against the Lebanese group Hezbollah. We've got Imran Khan standing by in Hasbeya in southern Lebanon. First, we're going to go to Stephanie Decker in Amman. She's in the Jordanian capital because the Israeli government's banned Al Jazeera from reporting from inside Israel. Steph, what more do we know about what's happening?
Well, we're slowly getting a clearer picture at the moment. You have around 20 ambulances waiting in the north of Israel to receive Israeli soldiers. They're being evacuated from the Lebanese border area by helicopter. Now, other than that, it isn't clear. We do know that in the morning there were various rocket barrages to that area from Lebanon into Israel. Of course, this is the border area where you have that buildup of Israeli troops. You also have two confirmed statements, one by the Israeli military saying that there were intense clashes in the border between Israeli soldiers and Hezbollah forces. And that has also been confirmed by Hezbollah. So it seems like it's the first face-to-face incident since the launch of the ground operation. And certainly, you know, as we've been reporting, Israel really has the upper hand when it comes to firepower from the sky. But it was always going to be Hezbollah that had the strength of the upper hand when it came to any potential ground invasion. This is their territory. And certainly it seems in what is potentially the first face-to-face confrontation that Israel has sustained heavy casualties.
Stephanie, thank you very much indeed. I understand, of course, you and the teams are going to be checking out to find out more information about this. But for now, Stephanie Decker in Amman, thank you. Imran Khan's joining us from Hasbeya in southern Lebanon. In southern Lebanon, of course, Imran, the scene of many Israeli attacks over the last few days.
That's absolutely right. And in the distance, we are still hearing artillery shelling and outgoing Hezbollah rockets. Now, Adesa is where they say Hezbollah say that they repelled Israeli troops. Now, Adesa is about 10 kilometers from here. It's very interesting because when the Israelis announced their ground invasion, they bombed three key areas to make way for that ground invasion, that ground offensive. Adesa was one of them. This is a key choke point when it comes to Hezbollah and Israel. And now we're hearing that there were reports of the first face-to-face fighting going on there. Hezbollah say they pushed those Israeli forces back. But there are two more incidents that I just want to talk to you about as well that Hezbollah have confirmed. One is in a large infantry force that they say they bombed with rockets in the settlement of Maskaf Am, and they say they achieved a direct and accurate hit. The second one is against a Israeli enemy forces gathering, they're calling it, in the Shemera barracks in northern Israel, which they hit with a missile salvo, and once again say they have achieved a direct hit. So Hezbollah very much fighting back. For the Odessa in particular, this is going to be seen as a victory for Hezbollah because they had their first face-to-face fighting and they repelled those Israeli soldiers back.
Imran, there's been a lot of speculation, of course, over the last few days, how much damage has been sustained by Hezbollah in terms of its military capabilities, particularly in the south. What does the fighting look like there?
Well, it still seems to be rockets and missiles from Hezbollah and artillery and airstrikes from Israel. But remember, this has been going on since October the 8th. Between October the 8th and 11 months later, Israel said it only hit about 10% of Hezbollah's capability. Then that was that. Then we had that intense escalation. We don't know. There is no Israeli estimates as to how much damage that they've done. But Hezbollah says very clearly that it still has long-range missiles capable of hitting Tel Aviv and further out. It also has a very large arsenal that it says they haven't used yet. Now, this is going to be interesting in the coming hours, the coming days, because of that Iranian attack on Tel Aviv using ballistic missiles. There is some talk amongst military analysts here in Lebanon that this might well encourage Hezbollah to strike at Tel Aviv itself.
Imran, thank you very much indeed. That's Imran Khan talking to us from Hezbaya in southern Lebanon.
Make sure to subscribe to our channel to get the latest news from Al Jazeera.